Tell me about the rooftop shows.
During the pandemic, no clubs were open. So I was like, I'm going to put on Instagram stories. If you've got a roof, a mic, an amp, and friends, I will come to your roof and do a show. And I did it every night for like at least 6 weeks.
So people responded to this, yeah. And you were actually busy doing business.
I was climbing ladders illegally to get on roofs.
Right.
I'd be in the middle of a joke, and neighbors, New York's a densely populated city. People would open windows, neighbors like, shut the fuck up.
See, to me, the resourcefulness here is amazing, and the it's a good thing to have offered yourself, your art, your craft, rather. Is it arts or crafts?
I don't think, we're definitely, I mean, art, calling this art.
I think it's art, yeah.
I know this isn't art. Sometimes I'll be watching a host on stage at a comedy club and people are going to the bathroom and he's like, number one or number two? And I'm like, we're not artists. That's not.
Okay, fair enough. Yeah. But when I was here in Los Angeles working, trying to become a stand-up comedian, the goals for everybody doing it then, get on a talk show, yeah. or get a situation comedy. And yeah. That was it. Those don't seem to be priorities. It'd be nice, but not priorities anymore. So yeah. 5 years from now, are you still going to be on the road, still doing specials and the occasional rooftop? or what dimension have you achieved 5 years from now?
I think this is it. I'm like, I'm talking to David Letterman right now. I mean...
Oh, come on.
I mean, let's talk about... Let's talk about where you're going to be, because you went from Barack Obama to Sam Morril. In 5 years, I think you're going to be talking to a homeless person. So,
5 years from now, if I'm talking to anybody, that'll be a miracle.